So in this circuit, the frequency is dependent on L and C by the formula 1 over 2 pi root L C. So by designing the values of L and C, you can achieve the frequency, the oscillations of any frequencies. Now let us calculate the feedback gain. The feedback gain beta is equal to output voltage divided by input voltage, because the output voltage is Vf here and input voltage is V0. V0 is applied as the input to the feedback and Vf is measured as the output. So Vf by V0 is beta. Now coming to this circuit, we across C2 we have Vf and across C1 we have V0. Now let us calculate the feedback gain. The current going through this series circuit is I, and the voltage drop across C1 is I into XC1, and the voltage drop across C2 is Vf is equal to I into XC2. So in Vf by V0, the I terms gets cancelled. So what remains is Vf by V0 is equal to XC2 divided by XC1. Now what is XC2? XC2 is equal to 1 over 2 pi FC2, and XC1 is equal to 1 over 2 pi FC1. So by dividing these two, what I get is 1 over 2 pi FC2 divided by 1 over 2 pi FC1. 2 pi of terms gets cancelled and we get the final value as beta is equal to C1 by C2. Now in this formula, I have written 1 over 2 pi root LC. What is the value of C? Because we have two capacitors here, C1 and C2. So what will be this C? C is nothing but the CT, that is total value of C, which is the resultant of this, resultant or equivalent of these two capacitors. As these two are in series, the equivalent series capacitor is C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. That is nothing but CT. So we have to calculate the value of CT and then substitute that value in the frequency. Okay, so with these two derivations, in the next class we will be solving the problems related to Colpitts oscillators. Thank you, students.